Alright, fellow pedal enthusiasts, here's a pedal patch cable video. This is George L. Here we go. George L. This is the Guitar Center brand. I believe it's called Livewire. I just got these today. Paid for, no sponsorship, anything like that. This is the EBS flat cable. There's like no videos on these EBS flat cables, so like this was a pretty much a blind decision to do to get them. They come in a few sizes and they're measured in millimeters or centimeters, I can't remember. So it's a little confusing. You might just want to whip out your smartphone and do a conversion. I know that the 10 millimeter or centimeter, excuse me, it's probably, I'm just an idiot. It doesn't matter. The 10s, these are the 18, by the way. So I think they're like close to 7 inches or maybe just a little above. I got some of the 18, I got some 10s. So, all right, first, spacing. These live wires, this is what they look like when you have them in a stereo configuration thing. That's kind of the spacing you're looking at. The spacing may end up being all the same. And with this, the flexibility of this cable, I mean, it's not that great. So there's that. This is the George L. So the George L, the problem is, well, we don't need to get into that. That's what they look like. And then here's the EBS. So you can see it's pretty much whatever. And another thing I forgot to show, and I will show again. Well, it's going to be hard to show. That's kind of like what you're looking at as far as... Okay, I'm going to grab another pedal to... So if you're stacking, that's kind of what you're looking at. It's pretty low profile. I'll go ahead and do that with everything else, to be fair and scientific, because YouTube is all about science, and that's important. Back to the George L. That's about what you're looking at, space-wise. Not a huge difference, but noticeable, especially if you're on some limited pedal board real estate, which the whole purpose of the board I'm putting together. Okay, see that? Okay, that's what you're looking at with that. I hope that's a good... I hope that's a good angle. I have no idea. Alright. So, got that part. Let's just move this. Put it back on the old board. Okay. So, next is this. This right here is the Walrus brand. It's not the Voodoo Lab plug, but I think they're about the same size. I just wanted to throw that out there because it does seem like it's a little bit smaller. We're going to see what kind of real estate this takes up. One thing to note, I guess, about the live wire is the cable is just not very flexible at all. So you can get them about this close. Okay, let's go to George L. In fact, I'm just getting rid of that cable. It's awful. I bought them in a rush. Gig. The George L's were going out, which is a frustrating thing about George L, especially when you have shorter cables like this. It puts a lot of stress on the cable itself, and it really, really does not have a good, like, it damages the connection, I'd say. And, I mean, if you have them butted up like this, you're gonna have problems. I mean, let's just be honest. I love George L, and this is not sponsored. I don't know if I mentioned that already. I bought all these cables. Alright, and now, the reveal of the EBS. Okay. So, like, we're basically butting up against the power plug. Let's put that right in the center. Alright, so real estate-wise, I mean, it's pretty obvious. Like, the EBS is super flat. The cable, I want to talk about the cable. Like, the flexibility of the cable, because that seems important. The cable is, you know, it's pretty flexible. It's, you can definitely twist it and bend it around. I mean, I don't know. Like I said, this is not a super scientific... God. This is why I only have 16 subscribers. I'll probably never break 100. I'll probably never even break 20. That's fine. I don't care. Having said that, please do subscribe. Like, comment, etc. It's a good squishy cable. It's really flat. It's hard to show because I'm on a... It's like I picked the worst color shirt to be doing this, but whatever. So it's a really low profile cable. They start at like $8 a cable for the smallest one. And they go up about $1 for every larger size you get. For every so on centimeters, they make them up to like 55, I think 55 centimeters or millimeters, whichever it is. I really should have looked that up. I didn't. And they go up to like maybe $12, I think. And you can get a package with, I don't think there's any price break or anything, but. And so the next video I'm going to make, we're going to do a sound comparison, which it's not going to be very scientific. It doesn't matter. I'm sure, I mean, these are your basic soldered, I don't want to say boutique, whatever. I think they're a Swedish brand. So I'm sure they're good. I don't know how long they're going to last. I mean, those live wire cables were terrible. I used them for 1 gig and I tried to return them, but they were like, nah. So that was a waste of $20-ish. So basically for $20 you get 3 of those live wires, and for $20 you get about, if you got the smallest ones, you get essentially 2 and have, you know, $4 and change. So I mean, that's what you're looking at basically. And so the next video, the part 2, will be a sound test. All right, thanks.